Senator, let me be clear. I'm not standing here saying that they've actively sold components. What I am saying is that we see activities at the site that would lend themselves more towards abandonment than for preservation.
I'm Anthony James, Director of Energy Policy. We were out at the site last Tuesday, and we did tour the site, and there's activity out there, and it does appear that they're actively pursuing abandoning equipment. They're removing a lot of the large equipment, the cranes and large trucks. Those are being removed from the site. So that's kind of step one. We learned that equipment that doesn't have a great salvage value, and that would be components that are in place, cannot be extracted without some great expense. Those have little salvage value to them, and so they are not being maintained. And those can be components that are fairly expensive. So that was the first concern. The containment vessel, it's exposed to the elements right now. So we asked where they're going to cover that. Their answer is we have no intent to cover that. And as I understand, if you don't cover that and expose it to elements, you're going to find yourself in a position where you can't recover the site. So the experts that I accompany on the site, it's an immediate response that needs to take place. This decision is very time sensitive.
So does ORS have the ability to file something to require them to at least cover it and protect it, if not mothball it?
SCNG, they're on a path of abandonment, and if you want them to go to a different path, that's going to cost money.